Good morning, YouTube. This is my kitchen lighting, and I've been running this lighting system off of solar power for over 2 years now. This is all that's visible externally here. There's actually two sets of lights. So right under here, you can see I've got actually a touch control dimmer for the under cabinet lighting. And you can see I've just turned on the lighting. It picks up a little flicker in the video camera because that's a pulse width modulated dimmer. And I have it dimmed down actually quite low. I think there's 35 watts of LED. I forget how much light. I picked these up from super bright LEDs. They're a 24 volt under cabinet LED, and they come in, I think I have a 4 foot strip and then a 3 foot strip and then a 1 foot strip to cover all my cabinets. Put a link to the item in the video description. Like I say, I actually bought these many years ago, probably 4 or 5 years ago, and ran them initially with a 24 volt power supply that plugged in here. So that's that light. This is also part of my kitchen lighting. This switch, let me turn this off. There we go. So this switch here, let me turn off the video light here, and you can probably see that turns on the overhead lighting in the kitchen. This is a 12 volt wall transformer. So it's UL listed. It's a class 2 power device, 12 volts, and actually this device only puts out 100 milliamps. So you might be asking, how can I light my whole kitchen on 12 volts at 100 milliamps? That's 1.2 watts. And I'm lighting my whole kitchen. I've got 6 5.5 watt MR16 bulbs being run by this one transformer. Well, this transformer doesn't run the lights. All it does is turn on a relay. And the reason I have this inside this box, this is in the US, that's 120 volt AC. It's a 20 amp circuit. In the US National Electric Code, this is called class 1 wiring. So you have to have circuit breakers and grounds and electrical permits to work on it, modify it and all that. This is called class 2 wiring. You know, your battery charger is class 2 wiring, your doorbell is class 2 wiring, your thermostat for your furnace is class 2 wiring. You have in-wall speakers, if you have cable TV, telephone wires, satellite TV with cables running in the walls, all of that is class 2 wiring. You could cut this wire with a wire cutter, and it might make a little spark, but it's not going to set your house on fire if you short those wires together, because these devices are limited, and the limits on class 2 wiring are less than 50 volts to ground and then less than 100 watts if you're talking about DC, or 100 volt amps if you're talking about AC. This is my interface between class 1 that's inside this box and class 2 right here. And you can see that wire goes up in there, and let's see where that goes.
Okay, here is the inside of that cabinet. You can see the two wires coming up. Here's the white wire is my power, 24 volt power for the under cabinet lights. And that's coming from, you can see that little blue circuit board. That's a little DC to DC boost converter. It's rated at about 3 amps. And I have it set to take 12 volts in on this side and put out 24 volts on the other side. Yeah, this is my fuse block for my kitchen lighting. I have the 5 amp fuse runs my overhead lighting, and you can see the fuse up above there that's feeding that DC boost converter is 7.5 amps, The idea is if you do 7.5 amps at 12 volts, that keeps you below the 100 watt level. So all of this up here is a class 2 circuit. It's under 100 watts, it's under 50 volts. And then this right here is a box that I built that has a 12 volt headlight relay in there. And you can see up on the top, that's where the wall transformer plugs in. That's what that little wall transformer does, is it turns the relay that's inside this box on and off, and that takes power in, and then these wires go up into my little junction box there. The two yellow posts are the power coming in from my solar battery bank, so I have like 10 gauge wire that comes through the attic, and then these two red and black wires feed my overhead lighting.